see that place, United Kingdom, and we will see airports, amusement park, and zoos over there. So for today, your pilot is Stuti, your co-pilot is Pandana, and crew member is Indrani. So over to you, Stuti.
Ma'am, I can't hear your voice.
Unmute yourselves to the land.
England is the other name for United. So you like the zoo tour? We'll be United Kingdom.
The very first is the London Heathrow Airport. This is the logo of the airport. It was originally called the London Airport until 1966 and now known as the London Heathrow. Is a major international airport in London, England. It is one of the 6 international airports serving the London region. The airport facility is owned and operated by the Heathrow Airport Holdings. In 2019, it was the 2nd busiest airport in the world by international passenger traffic, the 7th busiest airport in the world by total passenger traffic, and the busiest airport in Europe by the passenger traffic. Heathrow was founded as a small airfield in 1929, but was developed into a much larger airport post-World War II. Next is the London Gatwick Airport. The logo of the airport, it is also known as the London Gatwick, is a major international airport near the Crawley, West Sussex, England, 29.5 miles south to the central London. It is the 2nd busiest airport by the total passenger traffic in UK after the Heathrow Airport. Gatwick is the 10th busiest airport in Europe. It covers a total area of 674 hectares. It was opened as an aerodrome in the late 1920s. It has been in use for the commercial flights since 1933. The airport has 2 terminals, the South Terminal and the North Terminal. Next is the Manchester Airport. The airport is an international airport at the Ringway, Manchester, England, 7.5 nautical miles southwest of the Manchester city center. In 2019, it was the 3rd busiest airport in the United Kingdom in terms of passenger numbers and the busiest of those not serving London. The airport comprises 3 passenger terminals and a cargo terminal and is the only airport in the United Kingdom other than the Heathrow Airport to operate 2 runways over 2,999 meters in length. Manchester Airport covers an area of 560 hectares and has flights to 199 destinations, placing the airport 13th globally for total destinations served. Next is the London Stansted Airport. The airport is an international airport located in the Stansted, Mount Fitchett, Essex, England, 42 miles northeast of the central London. The London Stansted serves over 160 destinations across Europe, Asia, and Africa. It is in a base for a number of major European low-cost carriers, being the largest base for low-cost airline, Ryanair, with over 100 destinations served by the airline. In 2015, it was the 4th busiest airport in the United Kingdom after the Heathrow, Gatwick, and the Manchester. Stansted's runway is also used by the private companies such as Harrods Aviation, Titan Airways, and XJet Terminals, which are private ground handlers that are able to handle private flights, charter flights, and the state visits. Next we have is the Edinburgh Airport. The airport is located in the Ingleston area of Edinburgh, Scotland. It was the busiest airport in Scotland in 2019, handling over 14.7 million passengers. It was also the 6th busiest airport in the United Kingdom. It is located 9.3 kilometers west of the city center, just off the M8 and M9 motorways. It is owned and operated by the Global Infrastructure Partners, who are also the minority shareholders of the Gatwick Airport. The airport has 1 runway. And the next we'll be having the amusement park after a short video of one of the airports. An amusement park located in the New Forest National Park near the village of Over in Hampshire, England. With over 70 rides and attractions, the Peppa Pig World themed area is based on the children's animated television series Peppa Pig. The Lost Kingdom themed area includes 27 animation and animatronic dinosaurs. The park name is derived from the former Paulden's estate on which the park is situated. The park covers 140 acres of land and features a collection of around 80 species of birds and animals, in addition to the rides. The Milky Way Adventure Park. The Milky Way Adventure Park is one of the 10th best theme parks in the United Kingdom at Higher Clovelly in the North Devon. It is named as Devon's large attractions of the year by Visit Devon in 2016 and as one of the UK's best amusement parks by the Trip Advisor in both its 2015 and 2016 Traveler's Choice Awards and many more regional and country awards for excellence. The Milky Way has over 110,000 square feet of indoor and outdoor activities, making it the biggest all-weather family day out in North Devon. Thousands visit the Milky Way Adventure Park each year for its roller coasters, adventure rides, indoor dungeons, huge bouncing pillows, and many more exciting activities. Moving ahead to the Adventure Island. The Adventure Island is a theme park in Southend-on-Sea, Essex, England. The site of the theme park flanks the north end of the Southend Pier and has been a theme park since 1976, when the land now forming the west side of the park was purchased by the Miller family. The park used to be known as Peter Pan's Playground and later the Peter Pan's Adventure Island before becoming the Adventure Island. The site is owned by and managed by the Stockwell Limited. The park contains 33 rides, retail outlets, and numerous catering outlets. The night view of the roller coaster, which is very fantasizing. Moving ahead, we have the Sundown Adventureland. The Sundown Adventureland is the children's theme park in the Rampton, Nottinghamshire, UK. It originally opened as the Farmyard in 1968 and is owned by the Rhodes family. As of 2020, it has over 20 rides and attractions. The park has several themed areas, including the fantasy, Wild West Pirate and the fairy tale themes such as the Giddy Piggies, Robin Hood's Merry Adventure, Wild Ostrich Safari Ride, and the Angry Birds Park, etc. The roller coaster of the Adventure Island. And at last, we'll be having a video of one of the Adventureland. I hope you'll enjoy it.
Okay, so do you know what is the national flower of UK? Can you tell me?
It is a type of rose.
Yes?
It is a type of rose.
Yes, it's rose. Do you know
rose? And the flower is called the rose. And... Yes. And it has represented England since the 1400s.
Yes. So you know that rose can symbolize variety of feelings depending upon the color. Like pink rose is for sweetness. Yellow rose is for happy thoughts. And red roses is for love. So it symbolizes variety of feelings depending upon the color. Can you tell me the national bird of UK?
Ma'am, it's the European robin.
Yes.
Ma'am, I know what is the national animal.
Yeah, tell me, Madhushri.
Ma'am, that's the lion.
Yes. Do you have any questions? Or do you want to share anything? So the next country which we are going to visit is USA. And you know, it is the last country of our tour. Yes.
I thought it was up till 15th.
Like on 12th, we have the last country. On 15th, we will provide you certificates for your tour. Okay. We will organize one ceremony for you on 15th. Do you want to say something, Prakhar? Okay, so that's all about our today's tour. Hope you enjoyed. We'll meet you on Monday with a new country. Bye. Have a great weekend. Bye.